It is a privilege to hear very important industrial experience and knowledge from Kumar Ravi sir, and he's been sharing his knowledge in recommender systems in this session. And I really thank you, sir, for accepting our invitation in a very short notice. Thank you, sir, for coming, and over to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. So let me share my screen. To switch off the video. So, good afternoon, everyone. So today I'm going to give a brief introduction to recommender systems. So in this session we are going to talk about what is recommender systems, what are the different type of recommender systems. Am I properly audible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Then we will see if you want to work on recommender system, then what is experimentation pipeline for that, which we need to follow. Actually, in recommender systems, mainly two types of recommender systems are there. First one is the collaborative filtering, another one is the content-based filtering. So at first we will look at the collaborative filtering and their types. What are the pros and cons of collaborative filtering? Then we will move to content-based recommender system and their pros and cons. And then we will also look at if you are developing any recommender system, what are the metrics to report how well your recommender system is working? And then we will look into a lot of issues and challenges which we need to tackle in recommender system. And finally, we will conclude the session with the some real life examples. So here we see, like, as a user, we use different kind of application software. While using different kind of application software, we do a lot of transactions with that application software. While doing that transactions, we are generating a lot of data, and from that data we can develop some automatic system, some automatic you can say system which can process that transactions, and based on that we can recommend based on your transaction, based on your interest, what would be the your further interest, what would you like in future to do, or what would be your next step in the while doing some set of actions on some application software. So we can develop recommender system in different areas, and like whenever you are developing any website, any interface where user is interacting with that, from that which kind of activity they are doing, which kind of transaction you are doing, based on that we can develop some kind of recommender system. So here are some of the examples, like in which sector we can use recommender system. We can use in healthcare, we can use agriculture, we can use in sports, we can use in education, research, social media, tourism, and e-commerce. So, like, these are just very few of them. Wherever you are doing any transaction, where you are interacting with any application software, there you can you can develop your own recommender system, and that would help your users to, you know, use the your system, your application software more friendlier way. So if you go back definition, so you can say that recommender systems are software solutions that pick a number of products from the broad product pool and recommend them to the user based on their preferences. These are an integral part of component of the web. As I said, any website we can integrate, we can have one recommender system. So in a typical recommender system, we observe how a set of users interact with a set of items. And using that data, we can seek how users can like unseen items. So if you take the example of website, if the size of the website is growing, then a good recommender system can be developed, and it can play an important part in helping users to interact more effectively with large amounts of the content. So you can say the key expectations from a recommender system is to minimize the information overload by providing only relevant informations or suggestions to the end user. We can use recommender system in books, movies, web pages, news group messages to users, and based on the what kind of example they're having in terms of preferences. And most of the time, like in online store, we see like huge use of the recommender systems, especially in the shopping cart, where whenever you are buying a set of items based on your preference, you keep on getting some recommenders. You keep on getting some recommendation for some other products which some other people might have bought and which may have similar profile as you have. So as I said, we have mainly two kinds of recommender system at basic level. First one is the collaborative filtering, and another is content based. So we will come to know what is collaborative filtering and what is content based recommender system. Here, if you combine this collaborative filtering and content based, you can have multiple other recommender system as well. So some of them are also presented here, like collaborative. As we know, we have content based also, something called knowledge based recommender also we have, where we should have some knowledge about the user profile, what are the related things about those profiles. So then we call it knowledge-based recommender system. And then if you combine two or more recommender system together, then it becomes hybrid recommender system. Any question you have, then you can type in the message box. And time to time, I will go through the message box and I will take the questions. Moving further. So here are some more detailed classification of recommender system, what kind of recommender systems can be developed. So as I've said, the first one is the collaborative recommender system, which would be our prime focus in this talk, and content based as well. So first one is the collaborative filtering, or you can say collaborative filtering based recommender system. So in this, again, we have multiple category: user based, item based, memory based, and model based. Then we have content-based recommender system. We will see how this collaborative filtering recommender system is different from the content-based. Then further, in the previous slide, knowledge-based recommender system we have. There again, we have multiple, like two categories, constraint-based and case-based. We can also develop demographic-based recommender system. Then we can develop trust-aware recommender system. Furthermore, context-based recommender system. Further, if you combine different recommender systems together, then it becomes hybrid recommender system, like switching, mixed, weighted, meta, cascading, feature combination, feature augmentation, and so on. So now moving to some other different recommender system. These are called modern recommender systems. So here we talk about context-aware recommender system, semantic-based recommender system, cross-domain recommender system, peer-to-peer, cross-lingual, and so on. And these days, people are using deep learning a lot in the recommender system, like implementation point of view. Yeah. So we will come to this example of hybrid recommender systems. So at first we will see how this collaborative recommender system works and how this content based. And once we see both of them, we will see a lot of examples how we can combine. There are multiple ways to combine them. Like if you want to combine both of them or you want to include even further, then we can have a hybrid of them. So switching means like in particular scenario, suppose that you are using collaborative filtering, but in another scenario, it should automatically switch to the content based. In mixed, you want to like combine like both of the features together. Weighted, you want to give some weightage to one of the approach, like what weightage you want to give, higher weightage to one approach and less weightage to another approach. So like that, we have like different way of combining hybrid recommender system. Yeah. So now I was coming to the implementation point of view. These days, you know that most of the problems, NLP, image processing, recommender system, all those kind of problems, people are using deep learning based recommender systems. So we can use all the state of the art deep learning based methods to develop the deep learning based recommender system, like neural network, deep neural network, recurrent neural network, convolutional neural network, and so on. Now let us see some further, deep diving into the different kind of recommender system in different ways. So if you want to see at the first level, you can have like auxiliary information based recommender system. You can have domain specific based intelligent recommender system, context aware recommender system, classical recommender system, sequential recommender system. And further, you can look into in detail. I'm going to share this PPT with you. You can look at like, this is another way of looking at the type of recommender system, how these can be combined in different ways, and you can have different kind of recommender system. Now coming to the, if you are going to develop any recommender system, so you have to follow some experimentation approach. So here, this diagram shows how you can start with how you can start your experimentation in recommender system. So generally, for learning purpose, we start with some public database, like we have MovieLens database, we have Netflix database, Opinions database, Last.fm database. So there are some public database available on website that we can start with to learn how this recommender system can be developed. So once we have some data set, you can use different approaches here, like collaborative filtering, demographic filtering, content-based filtering, or you can even combine some of them, two of them, any two of them, three of them, or even further, couple of more together, and that would become the hybrid filtering. Now, once you have, like you know that, okay, you are going to apply this couple of them, then there are some model you need to have to develop these recommender systems. So if you want to go for model based system, then you have a lot of machine learning models, like a lot of machine learning model you can use, any machine learning algorithm, you know, neural network, logistic regression, random forest, whatever machine learning algorithm you know. Apart from that, you can also use fuzzy based approaches. These are some statistical approaches, like latent semantic indexing based approach, singular value decomposition based approach. You can also go for some Bayesian approaches, like Bayesian network. You can also use like genetic algorithm, like evolutionary computation methods as well. So in model based, you have different kind of models. Next one is coming to the another kind of recommender system, which is part of, again, collaborative filtering. So that is memory based. Under memory based, mainly we have like similarity measures based approach and aggregation based approach. So in further in memory based, you can have like hybrid user to user or item to item collaborative filtering method you can have. So here you can use like user to user k nearest neighbor method or item to item k nearest method or any other machine learning model as well you can apply. Once you like decide okay what model you are going to use, after developing the model, you are going to get the predictions. So once you develop the model, you want to get some predictions from that. and based on that prediction, you are going to compute the some metric like mean absolute error, root mean squared error, or coverage, how much coverage it is covering, or you have to do some cross validation. So why we are doing this, like once you have some data, you divide that data into training and testing. On the training part, you are going to apply these models and you are going to get some predictions on the test data here, and then you are going to check how much how well this model is working for recommender systems, and that you generally measure with the help of different metrics based on the kind of model you are going to use. Based on the model, you will have different kind of metrics, and this you repeat time again and again until you get some satisfactory result. Once you get the satisfactory result, it means your recommender system is finally built and that can be used for the deployment purpose. So once you deploy that your recommender system, that after deployment, that model is going to give you some top end recommendations, and from that top end recommendations, you are going to compare with the real how much recommendation you have given and how many of them are really liked by the end user, and that based on that you are going to compute your cross validation score using precision recall ROC and rank metrics.
Sir, sorry to interrupt you, but yeah. Like in the predictions, we mean sensitivity and specificity, we are talking something related to that.
Yeah, depends which kind of recommender system you are going to develop. Based on that, you can have sensitivity or specificity. And in some cases, if you are suppose that you are having some continuous values, and that you are seeing, okay, how much accurately you are going to get that. So based on that, you can go for mean absolute error or root mean squared error. So sensitivity, specificity. Here you can see the recall is nothing but the sensitivity.
Mm-hmm.
Precision is a bit different from a specificity, but kind of you can see here you can put sensitivity and specificity.
So already, sir, we are doing this thing here in the cross validation and all. So why, like, what we have taken a new place for prediction here in the diagram? Actually, this thing is dealing with what, sir? Predictions.
This is two kind of things are there. While you are developing any model, so generally initially you do what you do, like you have some whatever data you have in your hand. Based on that, you are like dividing the data into training and testing. So on the training part, you are developing the model. Means training part will happen here, or whatever model development will happen. Once you develop the model, you want to check how well your model is performing. So for that part, you are going to use the test data, and on that you are going to get the predictions. So here, once you get the prediction, you cross check how well your prediction is working, and that things will repeat. Once you are satisfied with your performance on the test data, then you go for deployment. So that is why you can say up to this one we are talking about the just model development and testing and like kind of cross validation on the training and testing. Right, but once you finally you are satisfied with your model on the performance on the test data, then you go for the deployment purpose. Once you go for deployment, what you do, you have to do the recommendation. So while doing recommendation, you give like top 5 or top 10 or top 3 recommendation, as you see in any commercial e-commerce website. Suppose that based on the model, they are giving 3 recommendations. Okay, you have bought something this, then you may be interested in some other 2-3 topics. Okay, 2-3 other items. And suppose that out of 3, if you are choosing any one of them, it means 33% recall is there. Out of 3 recommendations, you are going to select one. If you are out of 3 recommendations, you are going to choose 2, then your recall would become 66%. So like that, in recommender system, we always give some end recommendation, and out of that end recommendation, user may like or may not like, and based on that, we can compute the precision and recall. Okay, thank you. Moving next. Now coming to, as I said, collaborative filtering is the most established and most established and still so much popular method for recommender system. So let us see how this collaborative filtering works. So in actually, if you want to understand in one line what is collaborative filtering, so you can understand by this line. Tell me what is popular among my peers. It means the some other persons which are having similar profile like me or similar test like me, what they like, and based on that we are going to based on that test and profile, this recommender system is collaborative filtering recommendation is going to recommend the some other items what other peers has liked. So as you can understand from this term itself is collaborative. Collaborative means what some other people is liking, based on that I will like something, and what I am liking based on that, that recommendation will be improved again, and then based on that again recommendation will be made to other persons. So this will happen in the collaborative way. So a set of people, they keep on liking more than one items, and based on that this recommender system will improve itself, and based on that we are going to choose some recommended items. So the underlying concept of collaborative filtering is that multiple individuals sharing similar interest in an area tend to have inclination towards similar items from the other areas as well. So if we are having some similar interest in one area, then it might be possible we may have similar interest in other area as well. Furthermore, so here you can see that the similarity between users are figured out based on their past behavior. Collaborative filtering systems uses neighborhood-based approach to select a group of users who are similar to the active user for whom recommendations need to be given. The predictions or recommendation is provided as a weighted average of the ratings or actions of this group. So here you can apply some weightings with weightage as well. We'll see different ways of weighting methods are there. Weight is determined by the correlation between the group member and the active user. So we can see which kind of set of items one person has liked and what another set of items are liked by some other user, and what is their correlation. If their correlation is high, so it might be possible some one person is liking some one new item. It might be possible some second person will also like the new item. So that depends on the how strong correlation is there between the two or more people there. So here are the some of the measures which we generally use for determining the similarity measures, like cosine coefficient, Dice coefficient, Euclidean distance, Jaccard coefficient, Manhattan distance, Minkowski distance. So these are the some similarity measures which can be used. Here are some advantages of collaborative filtering. It can be applied when we do not have any explicit rating. So generally what we do, whenever you buy any item, you generally give some rating there out of 5. But in a lot of cases, where you do not have any rating. See, in that case, what you do, if you have bought one or two or more things, and some other persons which have similar test or similar interest, or they are coming from similar region, or they are having similar background, if they are also buying out of 3 those 2 items, so they have some similarity between them. So based on that, we can recommend third item to the second person. So here we do not have a rating. If we have rating, then we can understand how much we liked. So but here in this, if you have do not have rating, in that case, we generally rely on the some other people or peer who have similar interest, and based on that we can develop the recommender system. So memory based collaborative filtering is also there, which can make using which we can make the implementation of recommender system. And where while using memory based collaborative filtering, we can easily add some new data in incremental manner, and that can also become the part of recommender system. and model based memory based has like some advantage, and another one is the model based. In model based, we can show initially very high prediction performance, but if you want to add some new data, in that case you have to develop whole model in FS. In that case, this would become very, you can say, the resource intensive to develop whole this recommender system like from beginning. So there are some disadvantages of collaborative filtering as well. The first problem is like cold start problem. The cold start problem, like suppose that some new products are launched and for which you do not have any like or interest of any other people. So in that case, it becomes very difficult to recommend that product to so many new persons. So that is a major problem in collaborative filtering. Another is the sparsity. So what happens generally on the e-commerce site, we would have like millions of products and billions of users. So what happens, and we may have suppose that millions of products, so it might be possible we may not have sufficient ratings or user interest for all the items. So, or maybe even for a lot of products, we may not have any rating at all. So in that case, we can, like when we create metrics of this user and item and their like or rating, it would become very sparse, means a lot of entry would be blank. So due to this blank, if you want to compute any correlation between two users or two items, that would not give the correct result. So that is another major challenge. One major e-commerce site, that number of items sold are enormously large, as I said. Because of that, only a small subset of the entire database is rated by most active users. Hence, very few ratings are given to the most popular items. So in order to deal with like cold start problem, like there are some recent techniques based on the especially latent digital allocations. So these kind of probabilistic methods are there, where we look at like even though very few ratings are there, based on that how, or like we apply probabilistic method and it keeps on learning. Even we can go for maybe reinforcement learning based method, where we can keep on like learning based on the previous actions. So there are other methods as well available to handle the cold start problem. In some cases, suppose that you have ratings, in that case we cannot go for the collaborative filtering approach. In that case, we'll go for collaborating, but we will not go for memory based approach. We'll go for the model based approach, where we want to develop the some ML models and all. So another problem is the first rater. As I said, suppose that any item which is not rated at all, that item, how we can recommend to some new users. So that problem is another problem. Next problem is the popularity bias. Suppose that one item is very highly popular. In that case, what happens? That item will be recommended so often. So in that case, some new items will not be, you know, recommended in that cases. Some other disadvantages are also there, like we cannot understand about the customer dislikes, and a lot of cases like we will have implicit feedbacks, like textual feedback would be there, and that if you want to consider in that case, that a lot of time what people they write the some reviews, and that reviews their likes and dislikes would be mentioned in very complex way in using like natural language. So considering that one would be difficult in this case in collaborative filtering. In that case, we go for the content-based recommender system. Another major challenge is the scalability. As I said, we would have like billions of users and millions of products. So while having while creating the matrix, such a huge matrix is very difficult first thing. And suppose that if you want to keep on adding some more more products and more users, in that case, you need very huge amount of resources to develop your model, collaborative filtering model. So here, these are the advantages and disadvantages of collaborative filtering.
Now, sorry to interrupt you, sir. Can you please throw some light on, sir, implicit and explicit feedback?
Yeah, implicit feedback. As I mentioned, we would have some reviews, right? Yeah. And we do not know, like, especially until unless we employ some NLP based approach to process each, what kind of topic they have discussed, whether they have mentioned like they have given positive sentiment or negative sentiment of a specific aspect. Like whenever you are writing any review of any product, you generally mention about the different aspect means you can say product features. So in this case, in collaborative filtering, we do not have a specific rating there, right? Just they mention whatever they want to mention, they will write in the text. And that text, generally, we do not consider in this case, collaborative filtering case. For that, we move to the content-based approach. In content-based approach, we see, okay, what kind of content they have written, whether they have positive or negative, that we consider.
And so that means, sir, whatever the feedback which is given by the user, on behalf of the ratings which we get on the e-commerce site, and whatever the ratings we get through some techniques of machine learning, they are termed as implicit, and whatever the feedback written on the sites, they have been taken as explicit.
No,
in that way,
no, like generally when we give the rating in a star, no, 1 to 5 star.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. All right.
So that would be the explicit feedback, or sometimes
that is actually given by the user.
User, right? And implicit feedback, even in the content, like when you write the review, sometimes what happens? Implicit feedback, like in terms of, you can say feature names are not written, and they have mentioned their view. Suppose that if I am telling, for example, my mobile is slow. So overall, okay, we are saying the mobile is slow, but it is not talking about that its processor is slow, right? So they are giving review about the processor, but not the mobile, right? Because processor slow is a, you can say the adjective that is used for the processor there. So you can say that is implicit feedback. Processor is implicit here.
Mm-hmm. Because of the technical problem, the voice is low. So that means we are going inside the problem. Implicitly, the problem is coming. Is it so, sir?
Kind of, we can say. Like a lot of times when we write like reviews, we generally we do not specifically say, okay, this aspect, with this aspect, I am giving this review. They give some you know, natural intelligent ways are there. People they comment, and from that we have to understand, okay, if like as I said, has slow, so this slow would be related to processor here. If I'm telling that I cannot talk more than 1 hour on this mobile, so here we are talking about the battery, but nowhere we have talked about battery here, right? So battery is the implicit aspect here.
Battery is the implicit aspect.
Yeah, implicit aspect, which is not mentioned, but we have to understand from the context. Okay, if they're telling that they're not able to talk more than 1 hour, it means their battery is draining so fast, right?
Got it. So, yes, sir. It can be applied to any practical application in that way, no?
Yeah.
Okay, got it, sir.
Yeah. Now, let us move to some other a kind of recommender system called knowledge-based system. So in knowledge-based system, it is one of the most difficult recommender system to develop, because in this we have to have knowledge about the users in all around to develop the recommender system, and which is very difficult in today's era, as we have a lot of GDPR and other issues. We cannot access your personal information and all. But knowledge-based system is mainly based on the how much knowledge we have about a person. So if you have knowledge about the person, so based on your that knowledge, we are going to develop the recommender system. So in this, we generally rely on the domain knowledge, how much we have domain knowledge. And if we understand in this needs and preferences of the user, and then we produce some suitable recommendations based on the their details available with its knowledge models. So knowledge models are store information on how an item can address a particular user need. And this recommender system has knowledge about how a particular item meets a particular user need and can therefore reason about the relationship between a need and a possible recommendation. So generally here, like if you know, anybody is aware of ontological kind of things. So where what we do, like we develop a whole knowledge model, how much we have knowledge about any product that we are stored in the something called ontological form or using something called description logic. And from that we can infer, okay, if you know, if you like one thing, suppose that you like some pet or you have interest in pet, then surely you will buy some whatever products you have like are related to pet. So that is knowledge. If you know your interest, then only we can recommend. Somewhere if I mentioned that I like historical place, in that case, which kind of recommendation would be given to us? Like maybe dress, that kind of dress would be recommended, which is related to a historical thing. Or if we are visiting some tourist places, so instead of some, some religious or places, maybe some historical places, some fort, that kind of places would be recommended to me. Okay, that places you can visit, or even the which kind of hotel should be recommended, so that whatever hotel would be related to some historical, maybe some fort or something, that would be recommended. So if we express any knowledge, or if our system is storing some knowledge about any person, so based on that knowledge, it is going to recommend some item. So you can see that is a knowledge system is one of alternative of content based or collaborating system to deal with the cold start problem. If you have knowledge, then you can deal with this. But however, this approach is highly computational intensive, and major difficulty is that we cannot have all aspect knowledge of any item or person. That is the major challenge. Now coming to the demographic system, or you can say demographic recommender system. So,
excuse me, sir. Yeah. So yeah. In that way, sir, we can say that like in the knowledge-based systems, so because it is one way to solve the cold start problem, so in that way, whatever that person is, exploring on the net, whatever the knowledge he's been gaining from exploring or seeing any website and all, so in that way, that knowledge has been grasped and then it has been going to recommend the things.
Yeah.
In that way, we are.
As we have mentioned, like the knowledge based system is mainly developed based on the content based system. So as you said, when people are browsing or whatever activity they're doing on the website, so that information, if we are capturing, so that information will be stored in the form of knowledge. And from that, we are going to develop the recommender system. But in most of the cases, we may not have this luxury. Like people may not be exploring, some user would be very new to you, and in that case, you do not have any knowledge about that person. So in that case, if you are going to recommend anything, that may fail badly, right? So that is why whatever like problems we have, these are still open problem, and that depends on the kind of domain you are working. Mainly domain. So in this domain or maybe some applications, you may have enough knowledge about the kind of people are visiting to website or what are their interests. But in most of the cases, or in so many cases, you may not have. So that is why, see, these days a lot of like whatever e-commerce companies are coming, they may have like recommender system for each of the steps. Even while you are searching a word in, suppose that in Flipkart or Amazon, So if you're writing one word, what would be your next word? Or if you're writing some word that might not be explicit, because that may have a lot of context. You know, sometimes, let's take an example of apple. If you're writing apple, you might be looking for fruit, but you might be looking for mobile also. So there also a lot of system works in the behind. That is nothing but the recommenders, kind of recommender systems are working in the that searching. What kind of word you are searching, and based on the search, which kind of products it should bring. So for each of the steps, they have different kind of recommender systems. Some cases may have like content based. In some cases, you may have collaborative filtering based. So wherever you have transaction based, there, like if you are buying something, in that case collaborative filtering based thing would be there. But if some places, if you are searching, you are using the keyword, you are using some keyword to search, in that case they will use the content based. Which kind of word you have used previously, which kind of word you would you use next time, so that depends. Now coming back to the demographic, so in demographic, generally we see a set of people from which region, from which age group, what gender, what seasonality they are coming from. Based on that, we are going to develop the demographic recommender systems. So surely, like in this is like I guess self-explanatory. If we are looking for some products for kids, surely for other kids also similar kind of product will be there. Or suppose that some of the products which are meant for male and some other male is searching, then surely we cannot recommend the female things to her, not to him. So that kind of like this kind of recommender system where we take care of these kind of things, that becomes the demographic thing. Suppose that some people are from some specific region where there is so much cold, so we can never recommend them some this summer based dresses, right? So we have some people who are there from, suppose that they are from Kerala, and they, we know that 6 months they are having rainy there. So in that case, that kind of things also should be recommended to them. So it depends on the which kind of region they are coming from, which age group, gender, that matters in the in demographic recommender system. So this this recommender system, as we said, this information we can have. So this is very easy to implement, and it would be less computationally intensive. In order to develop this recommender system, we need to do some market analysis, and we need to identify demographic correlation among other user groups. So in this, we perform analysis by analyzing user profiles, either from the organization database or by carrying out some explicit survey among the users. So in the given area, which kind of products are liked by the people. So that kind of products only would be recommended in that area. The advantage of this approach is that we do not require any historical data, like in historical data of user transactions, unlike in other cases of content-based or collaborative system-based method. Now, let us see the content-based, which is another major kind of recommender system. So in content-based, generally, if you want to understand in one line, so it goes by this. Show me more of the same, what I have liked. Means earlier, whatever I have liked, based on that, you can show me, which would be like suitable for my need. In content based, generally, we do not go by the ratings. Generally, we go by the what kind of behavior, what kind of words we are using, instead of the rating, like 1, 2, 3, a star rating or something like that, or like, dislike. So recommendations are based on the information on the content of items rather than on the other user's opinion. So here, other people's opinion doesn't matter. Mainly matters what I liked previously and what kind of behavior we are showing by browsing or by writing on the web. So in this system, the objects of interest are denoted by their associated features. And we can use some machine learning method to prepare the profile, user's profile. profile of the user preferences from the examples based on the feature and description of the content. The underlying concept is to recommend items to a user which are similar to the ones that the particular user has already liked in the past. And we can compute the similarity of the items based on the similarity with the respect to the features. So based on the whatever like words we are writing, whatever behavior we are showing in the view, that would be represented as the features of persons. And from that, and when we do another activity, that we'll see if those features are matching, then we can recommend the another item. Generally, in this recommender system, each item would be represented as a multidimensional vectors using vector space model, and where each feature is represented in a dimension, means each column would be the features here. And in this, we can apply any machine learning model like Bayesian classifier, relevance feedback, neural network, genetic algorithm. We'll see with example, content-based recommender system. Wherever you have like some content, we go for the content-based recommender system means always you will have some text. Most of the cases you will have text, or you will have some activities that would be stored in the form of tabular format. Now, if you combine any one of them together, any two of them together, or maybe more than two, then it would become hybrid recommender system. So why we are going for hybrid recommender system? Because as we have seen, there would be some shortcoming of one approach, and that would be overcome by the another approach. As we have seen, there would be some shortcoming of collaborating filtering, then we that overcome by the content based. In some cases, content based system would have some shortcomings that would be overcome by the collaborative filtering. So in that is why we go for the hybrid recommender system. We combine more like ensemble kind of thing together. So what happens in this in hybrid recommender system? Like different kind of recommender system would run independently, and their results would be combined together to give the final set of recommendations.
So it will be very nice, sir, if some problem here can be discussed, like some realistic problem where we can combine all the type of recommender systems, and that is going to help us in the hybrid mode when we are making a recommender system.
Sure. We'll cover separate two slides, maybe at least two slides, or even we'll see if we'll, time will permit, we'll see some example through Python. So there, what we'll do, we are going to combine collaborative filtering and content-based method together. For a while, just sake of example, I give you one example here. As I understand, most of you are researcher or you are from academic background. Suppose that you are downloading any research paper from any journal, right? Any publisher or journal, right? So what happens there? Suppose that they have given some ratings, like if you have downloaded, or even not rating, you can have maybe citation as well, right? If you are downloading one paper, you may have citation, how many citations that paper has. That is one thing. So citation can be considered as one of the rating for the paper. Suppose that you are some other people who is downloading same paper. Okay, so you have common interest. So in that case, it means both of you are belonging from the same field. If suppose that paper is related to recommender system, and another person is also downloading paper from recommender system. So in that case, and suppose that first person has downloaded some other paper also from recommender system. So it is possible, based on the similar interest, the second paper would be recommended by the journal site to second publisher. So here, how we can say that, okay, these two set of papers are having common area. So what we do, we can apply here content based system here. Content based, what we can do, we can prepare something called documentary matrix. If you know NLP, we can prepare the documentary matrix where we can consider abstract, title, keyword, author, affiliations of the journal, and that we'll see that we prepare in the form of something called, you know, one vector or documentary matrix, and that will be compared with the some other papers which may have similar kind of words, and if those are having high similarity, in that case these papers are belonging from the same category and this paper can be recommended. So here you can see the example of like a content based recommender system. But if you want to see some other thing, like suppose that additional thing, as I said, like citation, number of citation you can consider, or if you can consider, suppose that I'm citing one set of paper which are published by some a specific publisher or maybe some specific author. So that information can also be used for the recommending the other paper for citation purpose to other person. Suppose that two or more author are from the same field, and I'm following some specific author, a set of papers by same author, and that person also following same author. So if I'm citing some of the papers of that author, then second author also may get the another recommendation for that. So some other example also you can we will see in future. We have set up two slides where we can see a lot of examples where you can see we can combine multiple recommender system, like especially the content based and collaborative filtering based. Now coming to hybrid. So as I said, in order to develop hybrid recommender system, you should have, like, there are multiple approaches are there which are mentioned here. Like one of them is a weighted approach. So in weighted approach, suppose that you have, in order to recommend a set of items, you can develop, suppose that five recommender systems, and you can, those five recommender system can recommend a set of items. And we can do some kind of voting technique. If more than three or more than four or more than two recommender system is recommending same set of item, that only we should recommend. That would be the one way. It means we are giving the vote. We can consider the vote. Or maybe suppose that in some we have multiple recommender system, and we know that in a specific field, one recommender system is giving better result. In another specific field, another recommender system is giving better result. What we can do? So for the next time recommendation, we can apply some weightage 60-40. So we can give 60% weightage to that one of the recommender and 40% to another. And then we can give, based on the weightage, we can combine the result, and based on that, we can give the recommendation. Similarly, switching, as I mentioned, in one situation, maybe one technique would work in better way, but in another situation, another technique may work. So this automatically switching may happen based on the context. At what context recommendation we have to make, based on that automatically our recommender system should switch from one to another. Another one is likewise we mixed method, where we can combine multiple recommendation methods together at the same time. Sometimes what happens, we can combine, instead of getting the combining the result of the recommender system, we can combine the features itself. Means some features we can take from the collaborative approach, and some features we can take from the content based, and that both of them can be combined together, and then we can develop the one hybrid recommender system. Cascade means this, the output of one recommender will go to another recommender, and that will refine the, like, find further recommender recommendations. So that is the cascade. Feature augmentation, like output from one technique can be used as the input feature to another technique. In meta level, so model learned by one recommender, that can be used as the input to another. So here is one example of hybrid recommender, very nice example of hybrid recommender system that you can observe. So in this, they have developed some or sound recommendation, as you are. Another like here, if you see any app, this recommender system is developed by some researchers, and they have published one paper. So they have developed this recommender system for actually sound. If you use any like song based app, in that app we can combine multiple information, like which kind of song you like, what is the genres of the song, who is the artist of the song. So these are the content. Now coming to the collaborative, means ratings. So collaborative, there collaborative filtering, how we can apply. Suppose that I have liked the song, and I have see some other persons which has similar profile like me. If I and so if I'm liking one song and they have similar profile, in that case this song can be recommended to another one. So like that, there are most of the recommender system nowadays when people develop, generally they combine both kind of things. So you are considering rating as well as you are considering the your knowledge, your profile information. So this is another way, like they have gone ahead with another one step further. So they are considering their social profile from Facebook, they are considering Twitter profile, and they are also considering some like Wikipedia items to consider how they are going to match, and based on that they have developed some recommendation, like song recommendation. So you can read here in the down, they have given some subtitle.
So, sir, if I am not wrong, this application, I mean, this recommender system portal is recommending the songs depending upon the priorities which we have gave in different this
way. Yeah. So they are not only considering different kind of information, they are also considering how much importance you are going to give. So weight is also considered here. Different kind of data is also considered, content based data mainly here. That is they are calling here context. So those mm-hmm. two are considered. How much intensity you want to give for one particular thing, based on that it is going to recommend you the song. So this is very nice example of, you can see the
weighted. Hybrid. Like on the right hand side, when these arrows are going on, so they are recommending that the name of the persons actually.
No, that should be the name of the song or maybe artist's name.
Okay, artist name. Yeah. Got it, sir.
So you have seen one example. So like most of the cases, as I mentioned, we need to have like different kind of information as much as we can collect about any person. The better recommender system you can have.
That is a perfect example, sir.
Yeah. Now coming to the different evaluation metrics. So once you develop any recommender system, okay, so you need to determine how well your recommender system is working. So before deployment, we need to test on the some hour, you know, some partial test data, whether my recommender is working well or not. So for in order to test our model, we have different evaluation metrics. And generally we can like consider multiple parameter or only one parameter for recommendation. So these are the actually multiple parameters, prediction, evaluation parameter, we have them. This generally when we develop the recommender system, we compare how much matching is happening with the test, you can say the actual and the prediction ratings and all that we consider here. Once you do the recommendation, we see if we have recommended an item out of an item, how many items are really liked by the people that we consider using these. So this is evaluations. We can say these are the, this is a prediction evaluation, this is the evaluation for recommendations made at the deployment, at the deployment. So generally we use precision recall, F measure, or ROC AUC curve. In some cases, sometimes we recommend as a ranked list. In that case, we see we consider half time or discounted cumulative gain. We'll consider cover this one here. We also cover how much diverse or how much novel recommendations we are making. It is like as I mentioned there earlier, popularity bias is the one of the problems. So that generally overcome here using diversity and novelty. We should recommend some new items as well instead of same items, repetitive items again and again. We should also cover from the different context, different domain. That is a diversity. So in order to compute the prediction accuracy, where you have like how much rating you are having and how much rating you are going to obtain, that we generally compute or compare with the help of mean absolute error, root mean or square error. And while doing recommendation, we use precision recall and F measure, how many items are recommended and out of that how many are liked by the persons. Novelty means, as I said, whatever the new items like are covered while recommending. Diversity, like different kind of items should be covered. In the rank measures, generally like we cover half time. So suppose that some people is liking something, so there would be some exponential decrease in the interest of the people as we move away from the current time. Suppose that if I like some specific song or some specific item nowadays, maybe after 6 months or 1 year, I may not have that much interest. So that is called half time. So generally we consider exponential decrease in the interest of the people. This is another way of looking at like how people would lose the interest into some a specific items. That is called discounted cumulative gain. So here also, there we are talking exponential thing. In here we are talking logarithmic. So these are the actually the kind of.
Sir, as far as I know, that as you shown this recommender system application one slide before, so here many students are from research background. I mean, they are doing either PhD or they are completed with or they are starting over. So in that case, can you please guide, sir, that the application which you shown earlier can be one of the research problem and the model which is going to make that application, we need to give out its performance and the accuracy levels. That can become a research problem, or it will be like a project. I mean,
yeah, as I mentioned earlier, I'm going to present especially two slides where we'll have at least 50 applications, not at least, then at least 30 applications. I'm going to tell you and in which direction you can start, like your research in recommender system. Even one of my PhD students from NIT Bhopal, they are doing so.
Okay.
Scientific is citation recommendation. Likewise, I will give you. You can take any one of them, even multiple of them.
Yeah, actually, sir, I've been asking and so curious because even my PhD is in the reputation systems. So yeah, my whole this thesis is going inside the security attacks, actually, what have been there in the recommender systems. So so many things which here we are discussing. So I was thinking for some problem that ultimately you said that you have been taking afterwards. So that can be the research problem that I understood, sir.
Yeah, security kind of thing I cannot say because this topic is like from my perspective,
No, sir. Actually, I was saying that it was in my concern that I took the security attacks because my supervisor was in a way that she always gets interest when we talk about the security. So ultimately, I have to search for the security attacks and what can be the challenges and what can be the measures taken in the recommender system. But in that
Okay,
way,
got it,
if
got
you,
it. Got I know it.
yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Then some of the scholars which are here joined with us, so I can always, they can be helpful so that they can find out some problem related to my research area, actually.
Yeah, got it. Yeah, straight.
Okay, sir. Yeah.
Yeah, responsible AI, responsible recommender system, these are the new things that people can look at, like
Yes,
from
sir.
perspective, yeah.
If I'm not wrong, sir, actually these the because we when I studied it has been categorized like that. It is the soft security and the hard security. So whatever the reputation system or recommender system tells us about the
Soft
soft
security,
security issues.
yeah, right.
Am I correct, sir?
Yeah, you're right. These are the soft security,
Okay.
right?
Okay, sir. Okay.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank
Yeah,
you, sir.
we covered that.
Okay.
Now coming to the how we can implement this kind of recommender system. Like one of them is something called user-based collaborative filtering. So actually, in collaborative filtering, I tell you, like there are two ways. One is the user-based, another is the item-based. So in user-based, what we look at the users, like what other users have liked. So whether our interest is similar to other users, if they have similar interest, then we can do the recommendations. If you look at the steps, how does this work? So generally, we will have a metric having like a set of items and set of users, and what rating they have given, like or dislike. So based on that metrics, like you can see user item metrics here along with the rating, that metrics we can consider initially, and from that rating we go for the similarity calculation. So as we have seen, we have different kind of similarity calculation method, like basic similarity measure, enhanced similarity measure. We will see again what are those similarity measures. So once you calculate the similarity measure, if like one two persons are having highly similarity, in that case we can have like recommendation based on the their common interest. So in order to calculate the similarity, we at first we select the neighbor, how many neighbor we want to consider, whether we want to consider at least two neighbor or five neighbor or more. So based on the neighbor, based on the multiple neighbors, we calculate the similarity, and then based on the similarity, we are going to make the if they are having higher similarity, then we are going to make the predictions. And once you the predictions and you find your model is working well, then you can rank the item based on the how much score is there, how much similarity score is there. So high based on that you can rank the item, and the items having the highest score, that would become on the top. So you can say based on the top and based top based on the based on the top n score, you are going to recommend the top n items. In this, mainly you can say in the user-based thing, we are computing the similarity between multiple users, what they have similar items, their what kind of similar items they have liked or purchased, so that we are going to consider. So this user-based collaborative filtering is more suitable when users are not so many and the user group is relatively stable. So you can see user group is not changing much. So another one is the item-based collaborative filtering. So in this, we look at actually items, a set of similar items. So in the previous case, as I have said, we are looking at the user's profile, what kind of item they have liked. In this, we see if this is the item, how many users have liked, which kind of users have liked. And then we see if these two items are liked by the same set of users, it means these items are similar. And if these items are similar, it means if one person is liking one item, then we can recommend another item as well because these items are similar. So this is called item-based collaborative filtering. So here, similar like in the previous case, we were comparing the similarity using some similarity measure. across the users, but here we are going to compute the same, we are going to consider the same kind of equations, same kind of method, but it will be applied on the like items instead of users. Once we see that, okay, these items are similar, then in that case, based on that, we can do the recommendation. So here you can see user-based collaborative filtering. Here we are looking at user-user similarity. In this, it is item-based collaborative filtering. It means we are looking at the item-based similarity. This is suitable where like user-based collaborative filtering would be suitable where number of items is larger than that of users, and users do not change frequently. Item-based collaborative filtering is recommended when number of users is larger than that of items, means you have a huge amount of users. In that case, we apply similarity among the items, and items do not change frequently. So these are the application scenario. We will see some similarity metric, how to compute them, similarity of the users and items. So one of the most popular similarity metric is called pure cosine similarity. So you know that this is the formula of cosine, where we compute the dot product of two vectors, and then we compute this second norm of the first vector and second norm of first and second vector, and then we multiply them and then we divide. So this is a cosine formula. So the only difference is in for user based collaborative filtering, this cosine similarity will be applied on the users vectors. In item based, it will be applied on the item vectors. Let us see this one with example here. Suppose that we have like 4 users and 5 movies. So, and this, all 4 users, they have given some rating for these, like some of these movies. Suppose that user 1 has given some rating to like 1 to movie 1, then movie rating 2 to movie 2, rating 4 to movie 3, and so on. So here we are, if we are following user-based collaborative filtering, in this case, what we are going to do, we are looking which users are having the similar interest. So if you look at this matrix as a using like just say without you can say the each numbers without applying any formula, just in naked eye, just briefly, if one user is giving higher rating to some of the movies and any other user who are giving higher rating to those set of movies, it means we can say that these users are having some common interest. So here you can see that user 1 and user 3 are giving at least high rating to the last 3 movies. So it means, it implies that if these movies are of common genres, so if one person is going to give higher rating to that movie, in this case, this person would also give the similar rating to another movie. So here you can see, as I said, these guys is giving higher rating to these last 3 movies and less rating to these 2 movies. So in this case, suppose that this user is giving less rating to this movie. So most probably, this person will also give less rating to this movie. But now, how we can like do what we have done through like manually here by observing this rating of the movies, we have concluded user 1 and user 3 are similar. Now similarly, you can see look at the user 2 and user 4 here, like they have, this user 2 has given higher rating to this initial 2-3 movies, and in this case this user has given higher rating to first and third movies, and here he has given less rating to this movie 5, and this guy also has given less rating to the movie 5. It means this user 2 and user 4 have similar interest. So if user 2 is giving higher rating to movie 2, most probably user 4 will also give higher rating to this movie 2. So manually we can easily see this. Now we have two approaches. One is very crude approach. Like suppose that we do not have any similarity based or advanced technique to compute this rating for this movie. What we can do, just we can suppose that this user has given XYZ rating to X number of movies, and we want to expect, we want to know how much rating he would give to this some new movie. What we can do, just we can calculate the average of these, whatever rating he is giving, and that average we can say that this average rating would be given to this movie. This is the one of the very crude approach. Now moving to the advanced approach, like one of the basic approach, not advanced, cosine similarity based approach. In this case, what we are going to do, we can compute similarity between the user 1 to user 2, user 1 to 3, 1 to 4, means across all the users. And then we will see, we can from this similarity value, we can see that user 1 and 3 are having highest cosine similarity value. As we have seen manually, U1 and 3 are same. Here we, from this also we can see. Rest we can see 2 and 4 are also having very highest rating. 1 and 4 is also having bit higher, but among them you can say user 1 and user 2 is also having bit highest. And user 2 and user 4 is also having highest. So here what we can do, either based on this highest cosine similarity, we can just assign if user 1 and 2, sorry, 1 and 3 are similar. Based on this, like user 1 has given 1 rating to 1, then we can say that user 3 would give 1. Another approach would be that, okay, let us take top 3 or top 5, as I said, top n neighbor. So in that case, maybe suppose a top 4 neighbor, if you want to see, then in that case, we can take the average of top 4 neighbor who are having similar interest, and based on that, we can take the average rating of top 4 people or top 2 people. That would be the another approach. So you can understand here. So this is called user-based collaborative filtering. So here we are, what we are doing, we are seeing the profile of users. Profile means what kind of interest they have, how much rating they are giving to different genres of the movie. And that's, we are computing the similarity between users. And if these two or more users, they are having similar interest, then we are assuming that similar kind of rating they are going to give for the similar kind of genres. I hope this example is clear to all of you, user-based collaborative filtering. Same thing we can understand for the item-based collaborative filtering. So in this case, what we were looking at the user's perspective, now let us look at the movie perspective. From the movie perspective, if you want to look at manually from this, you can see that movie 1 and 2, they are having, if movie 1 is having higher rating 5 given by the user 2 and user 5. In this case, you can see here it is 4, but maybe some other we have to look at. From this, let us go ahead with this. So from this, we can easily figure out. Manually, it is a bit difficult to say that, okay, which movies are similar based on the rating obtained by the users, different users. So manually, we can say movie 4 and 5 are having a bit higher rating, 5, 5, 4, 5. Here you can see low rating, bit higher rating are similar here. So you can say movie 1 and 2 are a bit similar, movie 4 and 5 are similar. This looks manually. Now let us go ahead with this approach, cosine similarity based approach. You can see that highest values are pairing movie 3 and 5. So 3 and 5 are having highest. That happens because due to these numbers, 3, 3, 3 are there. Otherwise, manually, if you see 4 and 5 would also have bit, yes, it is highest. 4 and 5 are similar movie. So what happens? Because these two movies are similar, 4 and 5 are similar. So in that case, if one user has given a high rating to movie 4 or maybe movie 5, in that case, for movie 4 also, he will get the higher rating. For movie 5, it is low rating. It means movie 4 also would have the low rating. because these movies are similar. Why these are similar? Because a set of people, they are giving similar rating to these two movies. And using that approach, you can see that using the similarity approach, same rating, what rating they have gotten for 5, they are assigned for the movie 4. And similarly here, this rating are, this 1 and 3 would be similar. 1 and 3 here, you can look at 31. Based on that, actually, we can see that, okay, what rating they have gotten for movie 3, that would be given to the movie 1 as well. So like that, in this case, we can say that we are looking at the item thing. So what items are similar? So if one item has gotten low rating or high rating, similar item would also have the similar kind of rating. So this is item-based collaborative filtering.
Sir, one question is coming in my mind. Like, if they need to set some threshold in the similarity values so that we can give the same type of rating? Because in the case, if the similarity value coming low in between any two movies, with respect to some other, like movie 1 and movie 2 is just 15, and movie 1 and movie 5 is 20. So some threshold needs to be set for that?
No, highest value we should consider. Cosine severity means they are highly similar. Higher the value means they are highly similar.
So that means then we will give, if the movie 5 is in an empty box, then the same rating of the movie 1 we'll give to the movie 5. Similarly, the movie 2 will give the same rating of the movie 1. In that way, sir?
Yeah, right.
So
this is the, okay. This is the basic approach. Like this keeps on increasing. These are the just basic, you can say the collaborative filtering is one of the method, right? And in mm-hmm. that we have seen, like in some cases we use user-based, where we see user-based, where we have a lot of items. So in that case, because why we are considering a lot of item, like user-based when we have a lot of item, because we have to compare less users. Where we have to go for item based, when you have a lot of users, it means we have to compare less items. So this we have understood one of the basic approach where we are considering the cosine similarity. But this
actually is why this question arising, because sometimes if we see that like the similarity ratio is, the similarity value is very high, sir, here in 34, though we have just 14 here. So giving the same rating to the movie 4 on the basis of this similarity, so we are doing the same thing with the 34 similarity value also, with the 14 also.
If you want to understand by this example, just understand that the highest cosine similarity value is telling these two movies are similar, so we should consider the highest one. You can see this is the 51 is the highest, then next one is the 49. So you can see the 3, 4, 5 are, even 3 to 4, see, it is 3 to 4, because 3 and 5 are similar, and 4 and 5 are highly similar. So most probably 3 and 4 would also be similar. And that is why we can see this value is a bit higher, not less, right?
Okay.
So if the highest value, it means most probably, if this movie are liked by the N number of people, this most probably movie 4 would also be liked by the N number of people.
Got it, sir. Got it. According just to the value increasing, we are seeing that the value more in the cosine similarity, that means that is more closer to the particular value which we have been comparing with.
You're right.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Okay. Now, as I said to you just now, cosine similarity is one of the basic approach. Now we have to keep on improving upon that. So this is the adjusted cosine similarity, okay? So this is another metric. So the one of the hurdle in the previous method was, it ignored the rating. Like sometimes what happens, we get the rating, suppose you have gotten the rating from 1 to 10 a star, and in some cases you get the rating of 1 to 5. So in that case, what we do, we take the average of the rating and subtract from the rating matrix, and all rest of the things should be as it is. So that is nothing but the adjusted cosine similarity. It means because we know that the rating values are different, we have to normalize those ratings. In order to normalize, what we have to do, we have to compute the average of the rating obtained, and that average rating should be subtracted throughout the ratings, and then the rest of the things would be as it is, as we have seen in the previous case. So this is called adjusted cosine similarity. So this is one of the bit improved method for the cosine similarity. We will see further, we are keep on increasing, improving upon this similarity method. So in previous case, what we have seen, that was for the item user based. Now this is coming for the item based. So in the previous case, we were computing the average of the users, like average ratings of the average ratings across the items to be subtracted from the rating. But here we are going to like you can say the average of the column here, and in the previous case, average of the row. Average of the row means average average of the ratings of the one each of the user. In this case, each of the items for one user. In this case, for given item, so for given item, ratings obtained by the set of users means average of the all the users. So here subtraction would happen based on the column average. Otherwise, rest of the approach would be same. Now next approach is called Pearson correlation coefficient. So previously we have seen cosine similarity, adjusted cosine similarity, and this is the Pearson correlation coefficient. This is also similar to the what we have seen in the previous case, adjusted cosine similarity. So in this case, we compute the correlation coefficient, and you know that in correlation coefficient, how to interpret that. Like if your correlation coefficient is, or you can say the correlation is, but from 0 to 1. So higher the correlation, it means both items are more similar, or both users are having similar interest. If your value is from 0 to -1, it means, sorry, actually it is, yeah, 0 to -1. So when we are moving down from negative value, it means your interest would be just going in the opposite direction. So if you have like lower the value, means lower the negative value, it means if you are liking one thing, then another thing would just you most dislike. So just we have to interpret based on the correlation value. Higher the correlation value, most similar items are, or people are having similar interest. If they are in the negative direction, correlation in the negative direction, it means if they are having, one item is having like, you can say the correlation between the two items are negative, it means if you are liking one item, as much you are liking one item, that much you are disliking the another item. Just it is reciprocal. So in this, we concluded the collaborative filtering. Let us move to the content-based recommender system. So let us see how this content, as I covered previously, in content-based recommender system, we consider the text or maybe some other thing, which kind of thing we are browsing, all those information we can put in the document or matrix format, and then we can process them, and then based on that we will compute the cosine similarity or correlation coefficient as we have seen in the previous case. So this part I'll just briefly cover. If you are aware of NLP or document or matrix or text mining, so this is that part. If you have any reviews about any movies, any product, that textual data we can process, and we can prepare something called document or matrix. Suppose that you have some ratings, that is called unstructured data. On top of that unstructured data, we do some text preprocessing like a spell checking, noise removal, tokenization, and all this. After doing this, we prepare something called document or matrix. So in the previous case, we have seen we had like users and movies in the matrix, but here what we will have, suppose that as I have taken an example of research paper, so we can have the research paper ID, means you can say document ID on the rows, And what are the words appearing across the different research papers? That terms or words would be appearing on the columns. Or similarly, a lot of other things can appear on the columns, and those that information would be processed. On top of that, we can apply some similarity calculation, and we can do similar kind of thing for recommendation. So this is just detailed example how this thing are working. These are the text mining process, different kind of text mining processing steps we apply for document for content based recommender system. So just skipping these, what are these things, you can go through your own in the PPT. These are the different steps how do we perform. This is an example of documentary matrix. Suppose that, as I said, you have some, here I have taken very simple example of DB, 2-3 document, but in some cases, instead of this document, for our editing purpose, we will have review 1, review 2, review 3, or maybe you will have, as I said, in the research paper, you will have abstract of one paper, abstract of another paper, abstract of third paper, like that. You will have multiple paper. So you can understand these are the multiple document or different research paper. And these all are the unique words which are appeared across all the research paper or document. And we represent them, whether it is appearing in this document or not, using 1 and 0. So as we have seen in the previous case, we had movie and user and movie metric there. But here now we have documentary metric. And from this we can check, like suppose that this doc 1 is the research paper 1 and doc 2 is another research paper. We can see similarity using the cosine similarity here. In some other, these are the different ways of representation to improve your documentary metrics. So this is called term frequency approach. Here, instead of writing 1-0, we write how many times that word has appeared. This is another third approach, like something called, this is a combination of term frequency and inverse document frequency. Here we give importance to those unique words as well, which would be very important. So these are different approaches to represent your content of the review or maybe if you are developing recommendation for the research paper. So whatever text, even sound, whatever you have, you may have to prepare something like this matrix, and then on top of that you can apply a recommendation approaches. So here you, once we have, let's suppose in some case you can have multiple documents, multiple research papers. We'll see a lot of other examples, like everywhere, like kind of words you are searching in the e-commerce site, those search keywords ID would be there, and what are the words you are using. If you are using particular set of word for searching, the next time you, what would be the possible words based on those unique words, what are used in the query, or what are the unique words used in the different research paper. And for that, you want to develop recommender system, you need to develop something called documentary metrics, and which will look like this. So what will happen for content-based recommender system, if you are preparing documentary metrics, you will have millions of words. And in that case, processing that many huge metrics would be very difficult. So for that, what we do, we apply something called feature selection method. We have different kind of feature selection method from a statistical background, even some other background also we have. And after doing that feature selection, we keep on applying some other recommendation method, as we have seen cosine similarity or correlation method. Even some other methods are there that we can apply, and we can see, we can do the recommendation based on that. Demo I'm skipping because we have limited time. These are some advantages of content-based recommender system. Knowledge of data for other users, and it doesn't suffer from the cold start or sparsity problem. And we can easily recommend some new item to any persons, new and even unpopular item. So it can overcome the first rater problem. It can easily provide an explanation why this item is recommended to the people. So that is why explainable recommender system comes here. And it can provide user independence through exclusive ratings, because we are not dependent on the rating. Instead, what you are writing, what you are using, what you are browsing, that we are looking at in this method. So we are not dependent upon the rating. So that is the beauty of this. It is a transparent method. We can understand why this is this. this item is recommended to a person so that we can easily explain. So we can also recommend item which is not like recommended at all or purchased by the user at all. Here are some disadvantages as well. In some cases, in certain domain, it is very complicated to generate the attribute, especially in the music and videos. And sometimes it happens over specialization, means specifically it will work for set of people, but it may not work for other people. And it is sometimes very difficult when we cannot get the feedback from the user, because it mainly depends upon the feedback. You know that in most of the cases, people easily can click a star, a number of a star, or yes or no, but generally they avoid to write reviews. So that is why in that cases, this collaborative filtering or this content-based method may not be implemented. So that is the major drawback. And we also need some kind of content which would have some meaningful features, which may not be possible in so many cases. We have to do a lot of engineering behind that to get the meaningful features. And user test that must be represented as a learnable function of these content features, and which may not be possible always. And quality judgment, determining the what kind of quality judgment we are of the other users, we cannot exploit easily. So what we have covered so far, what is recommender system? We have seen that what is collaborative filtering. We also have seen content based recommender system. Now coming to the collaborative filtering, user based and item based, what we have seen, those are called memory based collaborative filtering. As we have seen how these are work, how this user based and item based work. So in this we are computing the similarity thing. Now we can also develop model based. In this we can use matrix factorization based method, or we can use soft computing or ML based method. Here also we can use matrix factorization and even soft computing based method. Now I will skip some of the part so that we can come to the challenges and applications. Here just briefly I tell you, so these are the different improved version of the similarity calculation approaches. This is called set-based approach. So instead of considering all the items, whether you have a rating for given item or not, in previous cases we need to consider them, even though for a lot of items there are no rating, but in this case we will be considering only those items which are having some ratings. So this will improve further upon the whatever method we have seen previously. Now coming to the another thing, further improvement, this one also a bit I covered in the metric slide. As I said to you, if you are recommending something today, it might be possible after 6 months I may lose the interest in the same thing. So we need to consider time also as a factor. And generally, as I said to you, we have to use maybe logarithmic or exponential decrease. That is what we are seeing. So with respect to current time, how much we are, how long back we have recommended something, and that we should consider exponentially decreasing the interest. So next time, if we are recommending, we should give more importance to the something maybe which are recently recommended instead of which are recommended long back. So we should also consider the time. So these are some formula if you want to consider time also in the similarity calculation. Now coming to the model-based collaborative filtering. So till now we have seen whatever similarity-based method, those were the memory-based method. The shortcoming of memory-based method is that we need to load all the ratings into the memory, and then we have to compute the similarity. So that is very storage and computing intensive, and that would be time-consuming. So in that case, we are going for the model-based collaborative filtering. Model-based means we have to use some machine learning factorization-based method, and here we can also, using this method, we can also handle missing ratings and all easily, very easily. And these are some of the methods we can apply: ML based, clustering based, matrix factorization based. So this has also some problem, as I have explained earlier, like if you want to keep on adding some new items and users, then in this case, preparing whole model again from the beginning is very difficult. But here in this case, memory based method, if you keep on adding some items or users, this will not be a challenge. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of memory based and model based collaborative filtering. As we have only 14 minutes left, these are the approaches how this matrix factorization method works that I'm skipping for a while. Let us move forward. These are the methods how we can apply different model based method. Just moving forward, these are the further deep learning based method, clustering based method. Yeah. So let us see from here. So these are the different method, different recommendation approaches and different approaches, and what are the models available. And these are the different research papers where you can find about them. So collaborative approaches, we can apply heuristic based method like nearest neighbor, cosine correlation, clustering, or graph theory based method. We can also apply for collaborating model based method like Bayesian network, clustering, artificial neural network, deep neural network, linear regression, probabilistic method models, and so on. In content based, as I have shown you there, we need to prepare something called documental matrix. And like one of the most popular method is TF-IDF method for documental matrix. And then we can also apply clustering method there. And for model based, we can apply all the model machine learning based method as well. So here are the some of the examples. Now, hybrid method also, here we can apply voting scheme or linear combination of predicted ratings, or we can combine from one to another one. So these are the hybrid method. Here you can look into these papers to see how these hybrid methods are developed. First one is the knowledge based. As I told you, we can develop some ontology or maybe some user from user's feedback or from user's interest, we need to develop some knowledge. And from that also we can develop the knowledge based recommender system. Here are the some examples. Now coming to this slide, which Priyanka ma'am was looking for a long time. So let us cover this one. So here are the some real life example. We will take one bullet, like each of the bullet, one after another. So in e-commerce, I said you a bit previous, like I covered previously. So when you are buying any product, and so whenever you are buying product, you see a lot of recommendations there. So that recommendation you get from that particular e-commerce site based on some other user might have bought something similar item what you have already bought, and what other items along with that they might have bought, and based on that recommendation, based on that you are getting the recommendation. So in e-commerce, that is the one of the example of collaborative filtering. Apart from that, as I said, suppose that if you are searching something in the e-commerce site, so what would be the, if you are searching some specific word, what would be the context of that word? What if they know your profile there, suppose that generally, what is your gender, what is your age, which location you are there. So all those information also they can compile, and that information they will combine along with the what I said in the previous thing, what similar kind of people or what which some other persons which might have bought similar items. So all those information also you can combine together, like they will combine, and then after combining these two information, they would give you the recommendation. So they are not only looking at what other people have bought along with this particular item, but they're also looking at, suppose that some female has bought something, and along with that she has bought some personal needs, right, based on the gender. And I'm also buying something, I'm a male, I'm buying one particular item, but another item, first item might be similar to one lady, but next item would be related to that female. But for me, it might not be the case. So in that case, they may recommend based on my gender. Okay, this would be the suitable for the gender case. So they are combining both the things. So this is the example of hybrid recommender system. So we are doing collaborative filtering there. What we have bought and what kind of rating also we have given there. If you go for rating, then they will consider the rating also. If I have given less rating than another person which have similar profile, they will also give that less rating. So that is another thing. So you can see when we are combining multiple information there, then it would become the hybrid recommender system. Now coming to the e-learning. Whenever you are going for any website where you are learning any lectures, so you keep on getting some recommendations there. So how they would develop, they might have developed some recommender system before, behind that website. The first thing, suppose that I'm from data science, I'm from NLP. So if I'm liking any NLP lecture, so any other NLP lecture, which would have similar kind of title, similar kind of table of content, all those information would be compiled. So that is the content-based example of content-based. Now coming to the further, including the collaborative filtering example here. Suppose that I have liked some lecture, I have gone through some lecture, I have given high rating, and that lecture is from that a specific speaker. So in that case, what will happen? Whenever that speaker will launch some new lecture, or maybe he'll launch some new course. So surely, because I have given high rating to that professor, that rating will be considered there as well, and he will recommend the recommender system will recommend that lecture to me. So here, we are not only considering the rating, but we are also considering, we should consider the topic. If I am from NLP and if I have been given some recommendation for the time series or some other, maybe security, that may not work. Even though that session will be taken by the same professor, that doesn't make sense. So we should combine both the things. My profile, my interest, those both things should be considered. My profile is whether I'm from NLP background. My interest is whether how much I like some lectures from some people. So this is an example of e-learning. This one I have taken example earlier, like books and journals. As I said, if you are similar way we can understand, if we have given the higher rating to some book, as we have talked about in the learning lecture point of view. So if we have given higher rating, and based on the rating, what author they have published, based on the author they can give the recommendation, because I have given higher rating to the book which is written by the same author. Not only that, this would also consider the context means if I'm from NLP background and that book is from NLP. So what they will do, they will consider the table of content, they will consider the title of the book, they would consider some other information which would be available. In general case, we can consider like affiliation of the author, we can consider the abstract of the paper, we can consider title of the paper, we can consider which conference or which journal name, we can also consider the year of the paper. All those information can be combined. All this information are hybrid. Means if we are giving rating along with the rating, if we are considering other all information related to item or user, then it becomes the hybrid. So as I said you, in most of the cases, we are seeing the hybrid, example of hybrid in real life. Now coming to the another example, conference recommendation. Suppose that I'm developing some conference list. I'm developing a website where it will show the conference of security or conference of ML, ML or conference of AI or a conference of any other topic. So what will happen, suppose that I'm looking for any person is visiting to my website and he's looking for some website. He's looking for some conference, and that conference is going to be held on the maybe some security topic. So once they click on that conference, my recommender system should automatically recommend these are some other conference which is going to be held on the security. So this is the one of the topic. So here in this case, what they are considering the title of the conference, and from that title, not only title, what are the other call for papers, who are the keynote speaker, all those information they can combine, and they would compare with the other conference, and if those conference would have similar kind of words appearing, then that content should be recommended. Not only that, we should also consider, like, see here, as I said, demographic information can be considered. Where this conference is going to be held, which country, which city, like which institute. So all those information you can consider. Even you can scrap some data from conference, and you can develop your own conference recommender system, and you can publish book. Now let us take another example, foods and recipe. So suppose that I like some spicy food, and if I'm ordering might be this food thing. Yeah, let us consider example of Zomato here in this case, right? If I like some spicy food from one hotel, so it might be possible we can recommend, like recommender system would recommend a spicy food from another similar hotel or similar kind of, you know, like food. So that is the from Zomato example you can take. Coming to the recipe. Suppose that I have we have developed some website where it is presenting the recipe to like cook anything. So if I have browsed about some one specific recipe and another something is which might have similar kind of like process to prepare. So based on the what step they have, if I am liking one recipe, another recipe of the another item can be recommended. So that also this I don't think you can. You can have existing paper. You can look at like these things I have thought of myself when I'm showing you. Maybe recipe thing you can look at whether this kind of paper is published or not. You can look at if recipes are similar, you can make it like you have to crawl the data from the different recipe and then you can develop the recipe recommender system. News recommendation, which you are must be seeing everywhere. If you are looking at some. Maybe you are looking at the business news, then business news should be recommended to you. If you're looking at some maybe Bollywood news, then more Bollywood news should be recommended to you. So if you're looking at international news, then more international news should be recommended. If you're looking at a specific country-based news, then that all news related to that country should be recommended. So all these things, example of content recommendation. Similarly, in the tourism, huge examples are there, hotel, which kind of hotel, which area. So there they consider GPS information as well, in which location, at what, like geolocation, that hotel is residing, in nearby, what other hotels are there, which kind of buses do you like, whether you want like 2x2 sleeping, like what would be the timing of that buses, whether you like night buses, day buses, all those information they can, similar thing for flights, can be considered and tourist and recommender system can be developed. Now coming to the web advertisement, this is a very interesting example, actually, web advertisement. Any website, if you read about this, you'll come to know. Actually, you know, in the whole of Afghan, there is some, you know, hotspot. If you are placing the your ad at this location, this corner or this corner, which corner is the more, you know, easily eye-catchy. So that corner would have higher rating, and what a specific timing would have more visitors, what area location of the screen would have more visitor. So all those things in web advertisement, like recommendation system, can be considered, like can be developed. What area, what would be the size, how many likes you are getting, how many clicks you are getting, how many views, how many times I'm hovering over that news, how many times we are like which area I'm looking at more. So all those things can be considered in web advertisement. Similarly, you can develop for jobs like Naukri, Monster, Omni. So many jobs are there, so you can see recommendation based on the jobs as well as the like the candidates. If I'm a recruiter, I will look at the what if I have browsed one profile, what other similar profiles are there that would be recommended to me. If I'm looking for one job, then what similar jobs are there, in which area it is there, how much salary they are giving, what are the words I have used in my CV, how many words are matching with that particular job opening. So all those things would be mapped and matched, and then it would be recommended. Like it would be recommended. Similarly, this one we have seen in the example, like songs and videos, or on YouTube, or even on the if you are installing one app in your in your Play Store, then other similar apps would be recommended. Similarly, target marketing for training sessions. Suppose that we have seen multiple sessions in the last 2-3 days here, or 2 days, 3 days. If you liked some specific session by one professor, and suppose that same professor is going to give a lecture in the next session, then what, and you have, suppose that this time they have, this our organizer has collected the ratings. So whatever candidates have given higher rating for that particular professor's lecture, next time they can send the recommendation, okay, this professor is coming again, as we have given higher rating to this professor last time, you can also attend this one. So like this is the target marketing can be done. So similarly, in the financial investment, you can see like in which kind of company you are looking, you are interested to invest, whether you are in the interested in the mutual fund or whether you are interested in the blue chip company. So different kind of thing you can see, which kind of already investment you have made, based on that which kind of another investment can be recommended by the like your app. Suppose that Paytm Money or this kind of app, financial related app, can be developed. Similarly for insurance companies, so tons of examples are there for recommender system. But most of the cases, you should understand, you may have to develop hybrid recommender system, sometimes content based, sometimes collaborative filtering, and sometimes combining them, both of them together. If you go for the social media, you have tons of example in the social media, which kind of pages you like, which kind of friend you have, which kind of interest you have. Based on that, they would give the some group, which kind of group you like, and other similar groups are there, whether you should, you can join or not, that recommendation can be made. See, moving forward, location-based tourism, like what area you have visiting, whether you want to see some other similar visiting places in that area, that you can see. If you are reading any blogs in any blog sites, or that in Medium, then if you are reading one blog, similar blogs, even on Quora, question answer on the Quora, those things can be recommended. If you are looking for one doctor, some other like similar a specialties based doctor would be recommended on the different app. These two are existing recommender system are developed for the different purpose, for different banking and financial sectors. This is another example. Suppose that some a set of people, they are visiting to some restaurant, and how many people they are there, based on that automatic lighting, automatic guidance can be developed, okay, in which area they can go and sit, which kind of sound, which kind of music can be played for them. So this kind of thing can be developed, and these are the new thing. Suppose that on what kind of diet you are following, so based on that, the like diet plan recommender can be developed, okay, your next diet should be like this. So these are some real life example, and I guess with this, these are some other data sets, public data sets available. I'm going to share this PPT to all of you. You can look at for the these are the different data sets in the different domain. So we are there. So this is one other aspect, like it is showing, if you consider the banking aspect, so many ways, like so many aspect, a recommender system can be developed. So this is the one of the thing you can look at. If you take any example from that, like there are tremendous opportunities to develop a recommender system in the different areas. So this is one of the perspectives it is shown for the banking perspective. This is a summary. It is already covered almost, like we have seen memory based, model based, hybrid based. These are the challenges. Some of them already we have seen. I guess we are done, until unless you have any question for today. I'll share this PPT to all of you. Any question till now? Hello.
So, even we are waiting if any participant is having some query. I think that query, sir. So, ultimately, sir, I really want to thank you that you shared so vast knowledge in the recommender systems. And I am finding myself very fortunate actually, because already my PhD thesis in recommender system only. So I got to know so many things which I shall cover in my postdoctorate program if I really try to pursue. So yeah, I really thank you, sir, that the people here connected, they got so much knowledge and able to know that how recommender systems are really you know, happening in all the ways which we have been doing through internet, and this in our this natural life we have been ultimately we are ultimately connected. Hello.
I can hear you well.
Sir, so I think if any of the participant want to put his words regarding about the session, he or she has been invited. If any participant want to put anything, I really appreciate if any participant want to say some words regarding about the session. So with this, sir, really I found the session very helpful, and hopefully the participants got so much, you know, to those who have been pursuing in this field, and was a very deep insights you have given us in this problem. So many realistic applications you discussed, and the challenges, and various types of recommender systems, and how they can be they have been doing with the techniques. All we got to know that similarity techniques, and there's so many recommender systems. So I think that so many literature survey part is being covered in your PPT, sir. So it was very nice hearing you, sir. Got so much knowledge. I really thank you, sir, for accepting our invitation.
Thank you, Dr. Misra, and thank you, everyone. You can connect me on LinkedIn. You can search me. Yeah.
Hello. Sir, इसमें जैसे recommender system में filtering कैसे करेंगे कि किस कौन से recommender की वो रहेगी अच्छी recommendation? ऐसे कोई भी कर लेगा रिकमेंडेशन किसी भी प्रोडक्ट की, फॉल्स भी हो जाएगी, तो फिल्टरिंग किससे करेंगे, किस टूल से करेंगे?
ओके, सी फॉर दैट यू हैव टू लाइक सी देयर इज प्रोसेस राइट यू हैव टू व्हाटएवर डेटा यू हैव सपोज दैट यू हैव एन नंबर ऑफ पीपल एंड व्हाट एन एम नंबर ऑफ आइटम्स दे हैव लाइक्ड सो यू हैव टू टेक 80% डेटा It means you can say 80% data for which based on which we are going to build the recommender system, and then once you develop the recommender system, you have to test how many how much correctly it is working for the 20% of the data. This is the one way. Another way, like you can do this thing, you can repeat multiple times. That is called cross validation, tenfold cross validation. Ten times you can repeat this thing. Right. If it is working well 10 times on the same data, whatever you have, you can trust, okay, this may work. So initially for beginning purpose, you have to start with this. But if you delve into this further, you will come to know, okay, what would be additional thing can be done. But initially we do cross validation thing.
Sir, in that way, I would like to ask you one question, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you told about the cross validation, that is the testing and the training data which we need to prepare. So like sir, many of the companies, they do not disclose their data, neither it has been present in open source. So sir, there is a problem always while we build the recommendation system. So from where the data actually we construct, so that needs to be like
So initially, see, as I am going to share this PPT, you can see more than 20 data sources are there. You should start working on that. That is one thing to learn and work and develop your own model. And see, coming to the real life, until unless you have a real life problem, if you are going to develop for in real life some recommender system, you should have real life data. Generally, if you are developing your own app, then only you can have. Otherwise, see any other company who are having some app or any website, what they are having their own engineer. They are not going to disclose their data because you know this is very sensitive.
Yes.
That we cannot do until unless you do you for your own. If you develop your own website, you cannot validate that. Or if you do work with some collaboratively with some industry people who may provide you data, and then you can work with them. So a lot of companies are there who are working on the, especially on the this recommender system. Like most, not we cannot say most, 100% any company who are in the any field, service field, product field, surely they will have recommender system. Or any app you see, like if you are doing anything, surely they will recommend something to you. So if you are working for any company, then only you'll get access to the real life data.
Unfortunately, what happened when I was in a way to develop my recommender system, so I was not having any data from any source. Like I want the climate data something, but they not gave me some health related data I couldn't get. So in that way, I have to construct the synthetic data for that. So that is one of the very that very challenging point in my thesis, that I couldn't get the data actually, sir. So
yeah, I
like,
got it.
For any problem that we have.
Yeah, you're right. That is the fact actually. Any problem you choose, okay, if you cannot get real life data, you cannot showcase how well your algorithm or model is working. So that is why we try to think of, like as you said, you have generated synthetic data, but in your in my case, whenever I have worked, what I always take such a problem from which we can collect the data, public data. As you said, weather data always you can collect. You can always get the weather data. Not in India, but from USA you can work, and from USA data you can work. Geolocation based thing you can easily get. So a lot of data which are publicly available that you can, like whatever business, you can say the research problem you are framing, you can think of for given this research problem, from where you can get the data. Publicly data would be there somewhere or not. You have to spend the time how to scrap them or all. But otherwise, getting any company data, any customer data for any such research is very, very difficult until unless you have some collaborative research. Even in the company, it is very difficult to share. You know, they have a lot of like GDPR and those issues are there.
Yeah.
I have to access, then only I can access. Even I cannot share to my colleague. So that's, if you want to work on the real life data, you have to come to the welcome join our group.
सर इसमें रेटिंग सिस्टम होता है, जैसे कोई प्रोडक्ट आता है रेटिंग 1 स्टार 2 स्टार, रेटिंग सिस्टम और रिकमेंडर सिस्टम में क्या वो रिलेशन है?
रिकमेंडर सिस्टम इज डेवलप्ड बेस्ड ऑन द रेटिंग ओनली
सर. रेटिंग तो जैसे फॉल्स रेटिंग भी, जैसे अपन ट्विटर पे फॉल्स अकाउंट खोल के अब वो करते रहते हैं,
जैसे So that is, a separate part of a study, how to determine a spam, how to determine false reviews. That is a separate
study. That are security issues which are there that in the recommender system. Security, basically.
Yeah. So that, see, we cannot consider all the things together. That is very difficult. Right. There are ways to do that. Even people are like the big companies like Facebook, Twitter, they are having such system. You can give it a shot yourself. You just create your dummy profile and try to add some random people. They will block you within 2 to 48 hours. Because they understand, okay, if you are from this region and you are adding from other region, there is no connection, there is no common interest, and just you are keep on adding randomly, after some time will block you automatically. So they have this kind of thing. Coming to the ratings, false rating, false user. See, there are a lot of websites are there. We have submitted recently one paper. Even I worked in that regard a lot. A lot of websites are there, or some websites are there. They especially invite false rater, and they will give you false rating. So there are some intelligent methods we have developed. Come up with some intelligent method that will tell you this review is written by the false raters. So these are very different line of path to work in research. Recommender system is like bit different from them. We have to assume in this that whatever data you have, that is trustworthy data. If you cannot trust यू कैन नॉट ट्रस्ट डेटा मींस योर रिकमेंडर सिस्टम विल फेल. Yeah.
So ultimately, sir, these we can say that can be the challenges in the recommender system, the research challenges, the security issues, the attacks which we work on, that can build one of many, you know, the research problems we can go for in the recommender system.
Surely, yeah. So trustworthy recommender system, I guess, I do not remember exact word, but trustworthiness is one of the important. Even see these days, one term is a responsible AI. You don't do anything just, and you are not taking any responsibility. Responsible AI is there, one of them. Responsible recommender system, and from a security perspective, also one thing is there. I will message you once I will come to know. Okay, but it is there. These are okay. The recent topic, how to introduce these things into the recommender system.
And so one last question, sir. Ultimately, yes, the collection of these recommender system, I mean the integration of recommender system, it gives us the reputation system.
Reputation. These are two, I guess, two different things. Reputation. How do you develop your reputation in any aspect? That is a different thing. But yeah,
by integrating the recommendation,
you can use recommendation system. What kind of thing you can do so that your reputation would increase, and that depends on the specific domain, a specific area, how to improve your reputation. Maybe in one area, the one kind of thing you do which will increase them your reputation, maybe another kind of thing you do which will decrease your reputation. So there your new research problem you can coin, how to use recommender, how to develop a recommender system to increase your reputation. But collecting the data, building the data for reputation, what data are there, which kind of data you can consider for the increasing, what would be the constant to increase the reputation, what would be the constant to decrease the reputation, those things you have to think of and you have to frame. But that would be a nice topic, actually. That would be a new topic. I don't think that would be existing, how to use recommender system to...
Unfortunately, sir, my thesis is on reputation system for securing mobile agents. So this is like one of the topic which I took in my PhD thesis. So I came to know that the recommendation has been divided into two parts, actually, the direct recommendation and the indirect. And then I integrated both of them, then assigned the weights to them. And then I got the various parameters which you discussed, like confidence and the satisfaction ratio, which I got, what is the reliability score. In that way, then I finally calculated the final reputation of a particular host, actually. And then
assigning some weights, and then must be considering how much, how many aspects it is fulfilling. And then based on the weightage, you are telling, okay, this is repeated connection or something like that. Yeah, got it. Looks good.
Yeah. That way I connected. I connected the reputation system, sir, with the recommender system.
Yeah, looks nice.
Yeah, so in that way, sir, I've been highly blessed by listening to your talk.
Yeah, thank you. And wish you all the best. Yeah, thank you, sir. Me. I will just message you my email here and you can connect me on the LinkedIn.
Yeah, yes, sir, definitely, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
I will put it in the PPT, my email address, okay?
Yeah, sir. It will be too kind, sir, if you mail me your PPTs at my email ID.
Yeah, sure, I will do that. Can you can message me your email address, I will do that.
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes. Thank you, everyone. Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir. Thanks, Vanessa. Bye, sir.